Hey, welcome to EPN. My name is Victor Lucas, and we bring you the latest in everything cool every single day. That's our job. That's what we like to do. And thank you so much for joining us on another EP Live adventure. We have got some dedications here. E-Man, this is the first time I ever saw your show. I tuned in to see your take on Black Panther being nominated for the Golden Globes. I love your show, and I'm now a subscriber. Thank you, E-Man. It's great to have you here. Jake Hills also said he had a massive nostalgic flashback, you know, talking about EP with his buddies, and then was starting to watch our content on YouTube, and he's very happy that we're still making all kinds of fun stuff. Why would we stop? This is the most fun material on earth to talk about, and we've got a lot of it for you today. Let's get started with your rundown. There were a lot of huge announcements last night at the Game Awards, but first, we've got to talk about that new Avengers trailer. Disney and Marvel have released the first teaser trailer for Avengers Endgame, the follow-up to this year's Infinity War. It doesn't give too much away, just shows some of the surviving characters after the fallout of the last film's finale, with a glimmer of hope that they might still be able to beat Thanos. Endgame will also feature two Avengers who were conspicuously absent from the last film, Ant-Man and the sharpshooter Hawkeye, who appears to be going full Ronin in Japan. It hits theaters in April, and this trailer was magnificent. Very artistic, a nice little tease. Of course I want more. Of course I just want to see this movie. Disney knows that. Marvel knows that. Everybody on Earth knows that we all want to see this movie. We want to see how this all wraps up. We want to see our heroes take some charge. I love the look of surprise on Cap's face when he sees Ant-Man on the video screen. He says, is this a recording? I freaking love that. And also the Ronin reveal where Hawkeye is just like, he just looks miserable. He looks like he's gone through some stuff and he's ready for some action. I'm fired up like crazy. Of course, I'm very concerned for Iron Man. I don't want him to be drifting through space forever, but you've got to check out this trailer. I'm sure you have like four or five times. It's beautifully shot. Really nice, you know, acting little moments already in that trailer. I cannot wait to see a little more, but I also don't want to see a little more. I just want to see the whole movie. You know what I'm saying? It's coming up quick, though. April's not that far away. Now that we've got the big movie out of the way, let's take a look at the biggest announcements from last night's Game Awards. First up, Thanos hasn't stopped all of the Avengers. The new game, Marvel Ultimate Alliance 3, was announced, serving as a sequel to the 2009 action RPG, and most surprisingly, it's coming exclusively to the Nintendo Switch. The last game came out when the Marvel movies were still in their infancy, so Ultimate Alliance 3 will introduce characters with more recent mainstream notoriety, like the Guardians of the Galaxy. It lands next year. Mortal Kombat creator Ed Boon took the stage to officially announce Mortal Kombat 11. Like their last game, Injustice 2, Mortal Kombat 11 puts a huge emphasis on character customization, allowing you to personalize the experience more than ever. Best of all, we don't have to wait long because it's launching April 23rd. Over to another fighting game, with Super Smash Bros. Ultimate landing today. Hooray! Nintendo announced the first big DLC character, Joker, from the Persona franchise. That's the first of five post-launch DLC fighters planned for the game. It lands early next year. Bethesda announced a release date for Rage 2, May 14th. The game is being made in partnership between Just Cause 4 developer Avalanche Studios and Bethesda subsidiary id Software. Speaking of post-apocalyptic, Ubisoft showed off Far Cry New Dawn following a short teaser earlier this week. It's a standalone sequel to Far Cry 5, set 17 years after a nuclear war has devastated the planet. It launches February 15th, less than a year after Far Cry 5. Now, Marvel Ultimate Alliance is the thing that's rocking me the most. I can't wait for this. It's being made by Team Ninja, which is a cool developer to work with, and Nintendo is obviously adding some support here and probably making it work really, really well on the Nintendo Switch. Of course, it's a big surprise that it's on the Switch, but this is not a surprise property to bring back into the gaming space, especially after we've seen the phenomenal success of Spider-Man for the PlayStation 4. Now, I think Marvel is doing the smart thing here, and they're going to be doing nice little deals with their properties as exclusives on each of the consoles, getting the hardware manufacturers to invest tons of money to bring their characters out the way that they should be brought out into the space. And I also think that the game community is going to say, well, wait a second, why aren't we in this, you know, superhero domain? Because they take all of the oxygen out of the room whenever these movies come out. How much do we talk about superheroes on EP? Every day. And I feel like the video game industry cannot afford to avoid those properties any longer, and we need awesome superhero games. Now, that means Marvel Ultimate Alliance 3 has got to be incredible, and it's got to be a perfect fit. I think it is going to be. I think it's going to be one of the best games of 2019. Speaking as a comic book fan, I loved the last two games, and I thought, why are they sitting there dormant? Hopefully, we get, you know, Marvel Ultimate Alliance 1 and 2 also on the Switch as well, so we can have this nice kind of, you know, carry through. And hopefully, you know, there is a little bit of threading and a little bit of story stuff that's attached to the previous games. But I also hope that it doesn't come too far away from the launch date of Avengers Endgame. I really want there to be synergy there and people to kind of recognize, oh, wait a second, I can play a AAA superhero experience on a console right now. I'm going to go do that. I think that's great. Now, Mortal Kombat 11 is a surprise that has not really been a surprise at all, because we've known that Ed Boon was, you know, he's been teasing the number 11 over and over again over the last few months. We knew that this was coming. I thought that the Joker reveal, it's not the Joker that I maybe would have liked to have seen in Smash Brothers Ultimate, but I know that a lot of Persona fanboys out there are freaking out. Looking at you, Johnny Millennium, on Happy Console Gamer. I watched your video about the Game Awards and I saw your face talking about that. That's going to be a great addition, and it goes to further sort of embolden the property and enrich it, and also sort of mature it up. There's lots of different ways and lots of different access points for this irrefutable fighting game, which we're going to talk a little bit about later in the show today. So yeah, lots of stuff to look forward to there, but we have even more big news from the Game Awards to discuss. BioWare dropped the first teaser trailer for an all-new Dragon Age with the slogan, "The Dread Wolf Rises." That's all we know for now, so don't expect to be playing it anytime soon. It almost felt like that wasn't really necessary. We didn't really get anything out of that teaser trailer, just that, like, it was almost like a logo. Another massive RPG is coming from BioWare's former collaborator Obsidian Entertainment. They announced The Outer Worlds, a new single-player first-person sci-fi RPG that puts a strong emphasis on player choice. It will also have a healthy dose of dark humor. No word yet on a release window, but we do know that it's coming to the PC, Xbox One, and PS4, despite the fact that Microsoft just bought Obsidian. No Man's Sky developer Hello Games is scaling things down with a small new project called The Last Campfire. It's a stylish puzzler and is being made by some of the same people who worked at Frontier Developments on a similar game, Lost Winds. It wouldn't be a game show in 2018 without Battle Royale. Battlegrounds is getting a new snow-themed map called Vikendi. It's playable now on the PC test servers and goes into wide release next week. Valve is jumping on the bandwagon by adding a new Battle Royale mode to Counter-Strike Go called Danger Zone. It's out now. And Valve has also made the entire game free-to-play for the first time, which has already caused a massive spike in concurrent players. Finally, following the Crash Bandicoot Remastered Trilogy, Activision is remastering another game in the franchise, Crash Team Racing. The new nitro-fueled version of the game is coming to modern consoles on June 21st, and honestly, the Crash Team Racing is what I'm most excited about. I'm a huge fan. I gave that original game 10 out of 10 when I reviewed it on the PlayStation 1. It's still one of the strongest titles on the PS1, and I guess that's why we didn't see it on the PlayStation Mini. Incredible game, really tightly made, and honestly, such a tip of the hat to the design prowess that has always existed at Naughty Dog. What a company. They made a kart racing game that, you know, stood up with the best of them, Diddy Kong Racing or Mario Kart 64 at the time. Still, to this day, it's still ridiculously fun. So I really hope that the tuning and the extra design work that goes into remastering this game is on par with the Crash Bandicoot Remastered Collection. I'm sure it will be. I think this is going to be one of the most ridiculously fun games of the year, and honestly tapping into a nostalgic vibe that I just can't get over with that particular title. Can't wait for that. I also think it's incredible that Obsidian is still going multi-platform with The Outer Worlds, and I think it speaks to a highlight moment from the Game Awards in general, which was the kickoff point when Sean Layden and Phil from Xbox and Reggie from Nintendo all got up on stage together to talk about working together and playing together, and the industry kind of needs everybody all in, and when everybody plays, everybody wins. I thought that was phenomenal, but I also think that we are edging closer and closer to a lot of cross-play, a lot of, these ideas of game verticals not really being attached to hardware. It's going to be wherever there's a screen, you're going to be able to play these exclusives that these companies all invest in, which means that I don't think we're far off from a day when we're going to see, you know, Xbox content on Switch, or, you know, probably a lot longer for Nintendo content anywhere else, but you know what I'm saying? This harmony is a pretty cool thing to shoot for, because we have all of these different sort of invisible walls and barriers in between access to a lot of this material, and I think those have to come down, and I think that's what Jeff has been working towards in his celebration for the Game Awards, and it's personified by that moment, but also by the fact that Xbox and Microsoft will be attached to the publishing of A game that's going to be on the PlayStation 4. I think that's fantastic. It was a great show. Jeff really pulled it off, and there were lots of great highlight moments all the way through. The music was phenomenal. All of the reveals, like he is really working to make this, as significant an event for the game industry as E3, perhaps even more because of the multi-platform reach that he is able to achieve with all of the different carriage sort of options out there and all the international viewing options that are out there. I'm sure the numbers for how many people viewed the awards are going to be enormous. And I think it's incredible. It was the number one trending thing on Twitter. Everybody participated, and that is exactly the right way to kind of celebrate the event. So hats off to you, Jeff. You're doing fine, fine work with the Game Awards. That was an incredible one, and it was only your fifth one. So I know it's just going to keep getting better and better. All right, that's going to do it for our rundown today. Thanks so much for watching. We're going to have a lot more show for you. Remember, when you see the rundown clipped out as a separate video, please share that with all your friends with the hashtag PlayForever. Now let's move on to This Day and Everything Cool.